everyone. This video has been made in order to guide you as to how you should prepare properly for the Teaching Aptitude unit for the UGC NET exam, paper 1. In our previous videos, we had discussed the definition of teaching, and in this video, we'll be studying about the nature and characteristic features of teaching. There are about 10 to 11 characteristic features of teaching which also define its nature, and in this video, we'll be discussing about that. Number 1. Teaching has different levels. Number 2. It takes place in a dynamic environment. Number 3. It is closely related to education, learning, instructions and training. Number 4. It is essentially an intellectual activity. Number 5. It is an art as well as a science. Number 6. It tends towards self-organization. Number 7. It is a social service. Number 8. It includes lengthy period of study and training. Number 9. It has a high degree of autonomy. Number 10, it is a continuous process. And number 11, it is a profession. Let's discuss all these characteristic features in detail. The different levels of teaching. There are three levels of teaching, which we'll be discussing here. The first is memory level of teaching, or the MLT, understanding level of teaching, and the reflective level of teaching. This order is very important, since a lot of times the order in which these level of teachings are arranged comes in the exam. So the order is MLT, which is memory level teaching, then understanding level teaching, level of teaching, and reflective level of teaching. Talking about memory level of teaching, or the MLT, this is the initial stage of teaching. This level was proposed by Herbert, and it induces the habit of rote learning. Now, rote learning refers to memorizing a particular concept or a topic repeatedly and being able to produce it in the evaluation at the time of evaluation. And the evaluation system included in this level of teaching is of an oral, written, and an essay type examination. This basically includes a stimulus response level of learning, wherein a teacher teaches and the student learns the concept. So this is the basic or the initial stage of teaching. Moving on to the understanding level of teaching. Understanding level of teaching, ULT. This was proposed by Morrison, and it focuses on the mastery of a subject. It makes the student understand the concepts, principles, generalizations, as well as the facts. It not only makes the student memorize things, but it also provides an insight towards the concepts, which goes beyond memorizing the facts. It also provides an opportunity to the students to develop an intellectual behavior. And its evaluation system includes both essay as well as objective type questions. This is what is referred to as the understanding level of teaching. Moving on to the reflective level of teaching. This is the highest level of teaching, and it includes both ULT and MLT. This was proposed by Hunt, and this is a very problem-centric approach to teaching. The students are required to adopt some research approach in order to solve the problem. The main aim of this level of teaching is to bring about a reflective power in the student so that they can solve their life problems by reasoning, logic, and basic imagination. And the level of the evaluation method followed is of an essay type. And the attitude, belief, and involvement of a student is also evaluated. This completes our first characteristic feature, that it has different levels of teaching. Moving on to dynamic environment. A teacher is dominated by communication, which is in itself a very dynamic characteristic. And by that I mean is that teaching has to change according to the time and the place and according to the student. To understand the dynamic nature better, let's understand the concept that teaching depends on the interaction of three variables. What are they? Dependent, independent and intervening variables. Now the dependent variables are the students, which depend on the teachers for learning, and therefore they are considered as a dependent variable. The independent variables are our teachers, since they are in a position of authority to change the behavior of a student, and therefore they are independent of anything else. Now the teaching methods, aids and the techniques which facilitate the teaching learning process are known as the intervening variables. Now since teaching depends on all these three variables, that is the requirement of a student, the nature of a teacher as to how he or she wants to develop a student into, and the tools, techniques or the methods used by a teacher to teach its student is also a variable of teaching. And since it depends on all these factors, it is very dynamic in nature. Moving on to the third characteristic, it is closely related to education, learning, instructions and training. Another thing that should be kept in mind is that teaching goes hand in hand with learning. Teaching is basically causing to learn. Nothing is assumed to be taught unless and until it is learned by the student. And therefore, teaching is very closely related to education, learning, instruction as well as training. Let's see how. Education is a form of learning wherein knowledge, skills and habits of a group of people are transferred from one generation to the other by teaching, training, research or even by self-learning. Our elders, our teachers, our parents have provided us with education all our lives. How? By teaching us, training us in a specific skill, by providing us with research work. And not only that, we have also learned a lot of things from our own experiences. And all those things which we have learned by either of these options is known as education. Learning refers to a change of behavior of the individual as a result of any activity, experiences or practices. Whatever we are able to learn, which tends to influence our behavior, any experience, any practice, anything, is known as learning. A good example of this could be a change that age brings about us, which is also known as maturity. It brings about a permanent change. That is, this is a type of learning which once learned helps us to influence our own behavior in a permanent way. So this is self-learning. Instruction is the delivery of contents by a teacher. It does not involve any interaction between the teacher and the learner, but still it facilitates the achievement of teaching objectives. For example, a teacher gives an instruction to its student to complete so and so chapter. Now, there hasn't been any interaction between the teacher and the student, but still, once the instruction has been given, it is assumed that the teaching objectives have been fulfilled. Training. Training provides knowledge or learning about a particular skill or in a particular sphere of life. For example, training something towards the art of stitching is known as training. Since we are providing knowledge to a particular person to develop a particular skill or in a particular sphere, that is known as training. Indoctrination is the process of teaching a person or a group of persons to accept a set of beliefs uncritically. And this is the highest order of teaching. Syllabus is the summary or outline of the topics that we cover in an education or any training course. To summarize all of this, teaching brings about a change in the behavior of the students. It helps in improving the learning skills of the student. Instruction refers to acquisition of knowledge from a teacher. Training helps in shaping the behavior of and the conduct of a student. Indoctrination helps in the formation of a belief of a student. So these are the terms which are closely related to teaching. It is essentially an intellectual activity. Now, intellectual means involving a person's ability to think and understand ideas and information. And teaching is an intellectual activity. Why? Because it involves the creation of an environment for the enhancement of a student's ability to think and understand ideas better. So therefore, it's an intellectual activity. Moving on, teaching is an art as well as a science. Now, we all know that anything which is related to creativity refers to teaching. And since teaching calls for an exercise of talent and creativity, it is an art. For example, a teacher has to guide a student as to how to draw a house. Now, it depends on the creativity of the teacher as to how he or she describes the house to a student and how he or she makes him draw it. So, teaching calls for a lot of talent and creativity, which makes it an art. And what is a science? It is a collection of techniques, procedures, rules, skills, which can be studied and improvised. And so is teaching. It consists of a lot of techniques, procedures, and skills which a teacher has to follow in order to become a good teacher. And all those techniques and procedures can be definitely improvised and improved. And therefore, this makes teaching a science also. Moving on to the next one, teaching tends towards self-organization. Now, the people who are involved in teaching profession are sensitive towards the growth and development of teaching because it is very self-organized. It evolves around a very definite mechanism and to promote the standards of teaching. And the growth in teaching profession is very dynamic in nature. And the growth in teaching profession is very organic in nature and happens very spontaneously. Next is that teaching is a social service. It has been widely accepted that teaching is such a tool that brings about changes in an economy, in a country. And it is very useful for the development of any society. And therefore, it is also a social service. Next is that it includes lengthy period of study and training. In order to become a teacher, a person has to go through a very long and tedious process of studying and training so that he or she has the qualities of becoming a teacher. The next is that it has a high degree of autonomy. Autonomy refers to self-governance. And in the profession of teaching, everything from right from the curriculum to planning the activities of the year to evaluation criteria, everything is self-governed by the schools or by any particular board. So therefore, teaching has a high degree of autonomy. It is a continuous process. Teaching is such a process that never stops. Education is something which will never stop. Teaching and learning go hand in hand, and it is definitely a continuous process. Our last characteristic feature is that it is a profession. Now, teaching is such a profession which makes other professions possible. How? By imparting knowledge to them. There are various courses like B.Ed, M.Ed, etc. which impart knowledge and skills that establish the foundation of a successful path to a teaching career. To become a teacher on a school level, these are the basic requirements for any teacher. And on a college level, the NET exam is the minimum criteria. And just like any other profession, teaching is also complex, elusive, dynamic, and fluid. And therefore, we can say that teaching is a very dynamic profession which makes other professions possible. This brings us to the end of this video. And in our next videos, we'll be discussing more such topics in detail. If you like this video, do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to not miss any notifications from us. You can also check out our another channel by the name of DU High, which will provide you more such free videos for the preparation of NET JRF. Thank you.